May we come on this day at this hour, what it is about to occur, and turn our hearts to God that we may be blessed at this day. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, our Creator, Preserver and giver of all life. We come at this hour, God, to say thank you. Thank you for this day. One that you ordained a long time ago. Now it has come to pass. Here we are, God. First of all, we give you glory and thanks. Thank you now for all that you've done for us, all that you're going to do. That as these two individuals coming up through the years, Lord, only you knew. Only you know the hour, God, and the day that they will be here this day. Father, we ask that you will bless them, Father, you will. I realize, oh God, that there will be some ups. There will be some downs. There will be some dark days, Lord. But through it all, Jesus, you are able to see them through. I pray, Father, that you would take them in the hollow of their hand and hold them, Lord, closer to each other. And as rough times just come, they will be able to embrace each other and say, I love you. In spite of God, what Satan tries to do. I realize that there are tough times out there. Oh, but only you, Jesus, can see them through now. Hold them now, God. Pray that you would bless this service. Bless this union, Jesus. Even the children that are already, oh God, unite this family. One together today, God. I pray that I bless them upon them, Jesus. Keep them now, God. Bless them, and they shall be blessed. We ask it all in thy son Jesus' name. And for thine own glory we pray. Amen.
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 At this time, I ask all of my aunties to exit to the back doors for us, please.
Thank you. Thank you for always loving me. we can say we got a lifetime together.
I promise to be true. To be married.
The home is built upon love. Something like that is being standing way back there. The home is built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in the 13th chapter of Paul's letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is patient. And kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. Marriage is a companionship which involves mutual commitment and responsibility. You will share alike in the responsibilities and the joys of life. When companions share a sorrow, the sorrow is halved. And when they share a joy, the joy is doubled. You are exhorted to dedicate your home to your Creator. Take His word, the Bible, for your guide. Give loyal devotion to His church, thus uniting the mutual strength of these two most important institutions, living your lives as His willing servants, and true happiness will be your temporal and eternal reward. Let us pray. O Lord of life and love, bestow thy grace upon this marriage and seal this commitment of thy children with thy love. As thou hast brought them together by the divine providence, sanctify them by thy spirit, that they may give themselves fully one to the other and to thee. Give them strength and patience to live their lives in a manner that will mutually bless themselves and honor thy holy name. Lord, we ask all these things in thy darling Son Jesus' name. In the name of our Christ, we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Would you mind joining hands? And I just need you to listen to me. Well, I don't listen to me. You ain't got to look at me. Just listen to me. Brother Hines, Dale, will you take Michelle to be your wife? Will you commit yourself to her happiness and her self-fulfillment as a person? I need to read it fast. And to her usefulness in God's kingdom, and will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her so long as you both shall live? And your response is?
Yes.
Amen. Phyllis, will you take Dale to be your husband? Will you commit yourself to his happiness and his self-fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom And do you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live in your response? since they have made these commitments before God and this assembly, by the authority of God and the laws of this state, I declare that Dale Heinzman and Phyllis Michelle Baxter a husband and wife. Bella and Michelle, you are no longer two independent persons, but one. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. If you don't mind, congregation, I ask you that you would stand and recite with me the Lord's Prayer. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Mr. and Mrs. Dale Heinzman.